Wendy, we're going to get out those sweaters, umbrellas, all the above.
We're going to need everything.
Yeah.
We just don't need a snowplow.
Well, that's good.
So that's good. I was telling Adam over the weekend that I've never, ever worked a snowplow. I have no idea what a snowplow, well, I know what it does. I just know
you
I've never had to use it.
You don't know how to operate it, so that's fine.
We don't use those things
down
here. But we will need an umbrella. And that's already taking place. And of course, we are going to need some sweaters and blankets over the next couple of days as well, because colder weather is moving on in. Look at how gray it is out there. And you can see that all of this wet weather is coming in from the Gulf of Mexico, and it has landed. We are seeing rain on the horizon, and we are getting those showers on radar. And you can see that some of those heavier rains have already made their way on shore over portions of Manatee and Sarasota County. Oh, and there's more to come. So this whole system is going to last all night and into the morning hours tomorrow. This is going to be an all-night event, and it's not going to be severe weather. We're not calling for any severe weather tonight, but we are looking for some heavy showers, and the possibility of an isolated thunderstorm will also be moving on in. You can see what it's been like all day long, and now we're starting to get these heavier bands of rain moving on shore. So that's what's going to take place, and we could get anywhere from a half an inch of rain to a full inch of rain, maybe even an inch and a half. To our north, we're going to see the heaviest rains. To the south, we'll see the lighter shower amounts coming on in. And our risk for severe weather is marginal. We are not expecting to see severe weather tonight. Most of the heaviest weather throughout the day has been to our north, primarily around Tallahassee and Jacksonville. And then again tonight, we're going to continue to see this steady stream of rain coming on through, and that will last throughout the morning hours tomorrow. We'll see some cloudy weather when you wake up in the morning, and then things are going to clear out. And boy, are things going to be different. Tuesday night, we're going to be seeing our temperature readings getting down into the 40s, and we are also going to be seeing daytime highs only in the 60s on Wednesday and Thursday. And right now, we're very quiet as far as the winds are concerned. Things are nice and calm, but you know that saying, the calm before the storm. And of course, we're looking at those wind gusts of up to 25 miles per hour beginning on Tuesday and lasting through Wednesday as this storm system moves on through and the cold front comes on in as well. So today, because of the cloud cover, we only got up to a high of 73 degrees after an overnight low of 59 degrees. So a little bit below normal for the daytime high. Right now it's 72, raining at the airport. Winds are coming in out of the south-southeast and they're starting to pick up already. We've got a 1-2 punch going on. We've got the one cold front with this low pressure system bringing in all of the wet weather for us. That low is moving on up towards the northeast, and that's going to bring about the nor'easter across the middle Atlantic coastal region as well as the northeastern part of the country. And then we're going to get a reinforcement of colder air that's going to be coming on through, and that's going to bring about showers and the possibility of thunderstorms through Tuesday. And then what we're going to be seeing is some clearing skies and much colder weather. Beginning on Wednesday, we get a high of only 64 degrees, overnight lows getting down into the 40s. That's the big chill.